As if the wind and dust weren't enough to deal with, hordes of jackrabbits, driven by hunger, now invaded what pastures, crops, and gardens were left.
They ate everything green there was. The farmers had killed off the coyotes, and that upset the natural order of things, and the rabbits just exploded, and they would eat anything green they found, and they would eat your garden up.
There'd be thousands of rabbits. They'd eat everything. Eat the bark off the fence post. Dad put new post up on our place when he done it, and it was cedar post that had bark on it. And they ate the bark off of it.
To combat the invasion, entire communities began organizing rabbit drives.
You'd advertise it with flyers all over the place in advance. One Saturday afternoon on the farm of Joe Smith would be a rabbit drive, please come, bring a family. So on that afternoon, there might be 50 to 100 families show up.
And then the people would go out in a semicircle and then bring them in. And they had clubs, and they used wagon spokes for clubs.
And what it turned out is a peaceful picnic sort of turned into a riot. Dogs barking and yiping, people yelling, kids screaming, rabbits hopping in the air.
We'd kill them until we just give out, and then more kids would get in and go to fighting them, but they'd kill them by the thousands.
You'd stub the rabbits to death, which was an unsightly thing, and it was a horrible thing to do. They would scream, and I can still hear rabbits, the noise they didn't make. I went on one, and that was enough for me.